वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट फॉर द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर ज्योग्राफी लेसन ग्लोब लैटिट्यूड्स एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड्स. इन पास्ट पार्ट फर्स्ट वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज मीन बाय ग्लोब एंड देन वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज मीन बाय लैटिट्यूड्स. नाउ विल बी कंटिन्यू द सेम डिस्कशन अबाउट लॉन्गिट्यूड्स. So here we'll be discussing about what is mean by longitudes. So here are some definitions of longitudes. Longitudes are the lines on the globe which are vertical. We have seen as latitudes are the lines which are horizontal, but longitudes we can see the lines which are vertical. You can see in the image the line which are from we can say north to south or vertical lines, these are called longitudes. Okay, they are also called as meridians. Longitudes are also known as meridians. The prime meridian is found in Greenwich, England. So the time is decided from this meridian, so that is called as prime meridian, and that is found in Greenwich, that is in England. The prime meridian is 0 degree longitude. Okay, we have seen with latitudes the equator was there. Here we have prime meridian. Then lines of longitudes locate places east or west of the prime meridian. So east of west of the prime meridian places are located. So if you want to know position of any country through longitudes, it can be located from east or west of prime meridian, that is Greenwich. Then there are 180 degree of each longitudes and 180 degrees of west longitudes. Okay, then unlike parallels of longitude, all meridians are equal length. Okay, then each degree is further divided into minutes, and minutes are divided into seconds. So they are semicircles, and the distance between them decreases steadily polewards until it becomes zero at the pole. Okay, so thus it was difficult to number the meridians. All country decided that count should begin from meridians which pass through Greenwich, where the British Royal Observatory is located. Okay, and this meridian is called prime meridian. So I told you already its value is zero longitude, and from it we count 180 eastward as well as 180 westward. The prime meridians and 180 meridians divide the earth into equal two halves. These are like eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. Therefore, the longitudes of a place is followed by the letter E for the east and W for the west. It is however interesting to note that 180 degree east and 180 degree west meridians are on the same line. Okay, so this also you have to remember. So you can locate any point on the globe very easily if we know its longitude and latitude. For example, Dhubri in Assam. Dhubri is a place in Assam which is situated at 26 north latitude and 90 degree east longitude. Okay, so we can find out the exact place through longitudes and latitudes. So if you want to say where is the exact place, so we have to consider both. We have to consider longitude also and we have to consider latitude also. So we have to consider horizontal lines on the globe as well as the vertical lines of the globe. So this can be understood easily. Then so longitude and time, longitudes also affect times. So how it affects on the time, we'll discuss. Like the best means of measuring time is by the movement of the earth. So measuring time is possible because of we can easily measure the time by movements of the earth. And then we have to consider even moon also and planets also. Okay, and the sun regularly rises and sets every day, you know already this, and naturally it is the best timekeeper throughout the world. Means it through positioning of sunrise and sunset, the times are generally decided. Local time can be recognized by the shadow cast by the sun, which is shortest at noon, okay, and longest at sunrise and sunset. When the prime meridian of Greenwich has the sun at the highest point in the sky, all the places along this meridian will have midday or moon. Okay, as the earth rotates from west to east, those places of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time, and those to the west will be behind it. Okay, I am repeating, as the earth is rotating from west to east, those places, the places which are to the east of Greenwich, I told you where is Greenwich, that is prime meridian, which are east to the Greenwich, will go ahead of what? Greenwich time. And those places which will come to the west of Greenwich will be behind, means the time will be behind, and the places which are on the east of Greenwich, their time will be ahead, means they will be going ahead by the time as Greenwich time. Okay, the rate of difference can be calculated as follow. Here is a calculation criteria, we can say. The earth rotates 360 degree in about 24 hours, which means 15 hour or 1 degree in 4 minutes. So if you calculate this in numbers or minutes, so it will take this much time. Thus it is, when it is 12 noon at Greenwich, the time at 15 east of Greenwich will be 15 multiple 4, that is 60 minutes, that is 1 hour ahead of Greenwich time. I hope you understood. As the Greenwich time or the changes, so you can find in eastward and east westward of Greenwich, there will be difference. At any place a watch can be adjusted to read 12 o'clock when the sun is at the highest point in the sky. So when the sun is on our head or noon time, so that can be called as a highest point, or you can say that is exactly 12 noon. So this can be identified at any part. So when we are standing and we can see that the sun is exactly on the head at noon, so the time is 12 o'clock of that particular country or that particular local time. The time shown by such a watch will be local time. Okay, suppose you are there in any one part of country, and you could find that this is the time when I am getting the reach, or the sun is on exactly my head. So that is the local time of that country. So we can say that local time get changes. It changes according to countries and areas. Like it doesn't meet if there is 5 o'clock in India, the same time is in England or other part of the world. So there is different time, and it depends on the position from the Greenwich. So from which side of the Greenwich that country is, and how much is the distance from the Greenwich, and longitude, latitude, both are important. So according to that, time is decided. If you see in India, most of the places have the time zones. We have time zones where a particular time is followed for that particular time is observed throughout the country. It is possible, or sometimes it's not possible with the some of countries. Some country have the same. It depend on the size of the country. If the country is small, there are chances there is only one local time. But country like Russia, it is being a vast country, or it is being a big country, so there are chances. And India, Russia, there are different local times. So local time can be different. So why do we have standard time? So why we required the standard time? So that is also explained. The local time of places which are on different meridians are bound to differ. Okay, they will be differing, they will be different. For example, it will be difficult to prepare a timetable for a train which cross several longitudes. Okay, in India, for example, there will be a difference of about 1 hour and 45 minutes in the local times of Dwarka in Gujarat and Dibrugarh in Assam. So it is therefore necessary to adapt the local time of some central meridian of a country as what we call as the standard time of the country. Okay, so it means that if you go to one part of Gujarat and if you go to one part of Assam, so there are differences of time because the distance is longer. So for that reason, so there should not be misunderstanding of the time, especially for the trains or time areas. So country has decided, each country has decided a particular standard time that will be fixed, and so that there will not be confusion in the mind of the people. So in India, longitudes of 82 and half east is treated as the standard meridian. I am repeating, that is important for standard time, as in India, longitude of 82 and half east is treated as the standard meridian. Okay, that area is considered as the local standard time. The local time at this meridian is taken as the standard time for the whole country. दैट्स वाई इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड टाइम और IST. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ़ यू आर गोइंग एट एयरपोर्ट एंड यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द टाइम देर आर टू क्लॉक्स द वन क्लॉक इज इंडियन टाइम एंड द अदर इज द इंटरनेशनल टाइम वेयर द इंटरनेशनल टाइम इज ऑल्सो फिक्स द सेम वे फॉर द कंट्री ऑल्सो IST और दैट इज इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड टाइम इज फिक्स्ड एंड दैट इज आई हैव टोल्ड यू ऑन विच लॉन्गिट्यूड इट इज डिसाइडेड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वी हैव स्टैंडर्ड टाइम ओके सो वी हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस लाइक सम आई टोल्ड यू लाइक सम कंट्रीज हैव ग्रेट लॉन्गिट्यूडल एक्सटेंट ओके सो And so they have adopted more than one standard time. So they have adopted more than one standard time. For example, Russia. There are so many as 11 standard times. Can you believe in Russia there are 11 standard time zones or time. The earth has been divided into 24 time zones. How many? 24 time zones of the 1 hour. 1 hour each. Okay. So you have to remember this also. So if you want to know the positioning of India from the Greenwich. So India is located east of Greenwich. Where is position of India? India is located east of Greenwich, that is 82 degree and 30 minutes east. India is located on the east of Greenwich at 82 degree and 30 minute east. It's 5 hours and 30 minutes ahead of GMT. What is GMT? Greenwich or that is time we have decided the word time we can say GMT so there is a difference of how much hours there is a difference of 5 hours and 30 minutes of India from the Greenwich time so it will be 7:30 p.m. in India when it is 2 p.m. noon in London so it means when in London We can say in London there will be time of 2 o'clock of afternoon. Okay, there will be 2 o'clock of afternoon in London, but in India, what will be the time? In India, the time will be 7:30 p.m. So this much difference you can notice. So, like in India, there will be 7:30 p.m. when. The same time when there will be 7:30 p.m. in India, the same time in England, the time will be 2 o'clock. So this much different is seen from India and England. So I hope you have understood about these longitudes and latitudes. At last we will have a comparison. Latitudes are vertical lines. You can see in the image. They are vertical and longitudes are So, they are latitudes are horizontal lines and longitudes are vertical lines. Okay, so through this figure you can identify. Like latitudes are horizontal lines and longitudes are vertical lines. Okay, I hope you must have understood it.